Welcome, friends, patrons, critics. In our story, you will meet a doctor of the law who, although learned, is none too bright in the ways of the world. If you stay with us for a while, you will get to meet our hero, a young man by the name of Kalamako Guadani, who has just returned from Paris and lives in a house just up the street. His problem is, he loved too much a pretty girl, and how she was taken advantage of by him, our story will explain. Our comedy has the title of Mandragola, the Mandrake Root. And if all of this seems unimportant and too trivial to come from a man who is serious and wise, then forgive the storyteller. He is only trying with these little trifles to brighten up your mundane lives. No wonder then that those who see their efforts scorned do not exert themselves to do the work which the wind destroys and the rain washes away. But enough of those who speak evil. Let's get back to our comedy before it's too late. Our story begins with Kalamako and his faithful servant, Ciro. They will explain everything. So, pay attention and listen carefully to La Mandragola.
Come on, Ciro, keep up. I believe you're amazed by my sudden departure from Paris. I'm probably wondering right now why I've been here almost a month without doing anything. You know, as you know, I lost my family at the age of 10. My guardian sent me to Paris, where I lived for 20 years. And then when King Charles started those disastrous wars that destroyed Italy, I decided not to return home, but to remain in Paris, judging life there to be far more secure than here in Italy. Having sold all my belongings apart from the house, I lived for 10 very happy years in Paris, spending my time partly studying, partly enjoying myself, partly dealing in business, but never letting one occupation interfere with the others. And in so doing, as you know, I lived a peaceful life, pleasing all, offending no one. But fortune felt I was perhaps too lucky and saw to it that one Camillo Calfucci ran into me in Paris.
I often entertained him, as I did other Sardinians. And speaking to him one day, it happened that we began to argue about whether the most beautiful women lived in France or in Italy. Since I could not argue about Italian women, having left the country as a small boy, another Sardinian at this gathering defended the French, while Camillo took the Italian side. After much discussion on both sides, Camillo got angry and claimed that he had a relative whose beauty alone could win the argument, even if every other Italian girl were an ugly monster.
He said her name was Madonna Lucrezia, the wife of Messer Nicia Calfucci. And he spoke of her so highly, praising her manner and beauty so much, we were all dumbfounded. I set out to see her. And on my arrival, I was to find that the fame of Lucrezia's beauty was nothing compared to her real beauty, something which rarely occurs. I want her so badly, Ciro. I'm almost out of my mind.
Well, had you mentioned this to me in Paris, I would have known how best to advise you, but I don't know what to say.
I'm telling you not because I want your advice, but because I need to get this off my chest. And I want you to be ready to help me, if necessary.
I am more than ready. But do you have any hope of success?
Oh, little or none. I'll explain.
In the first place, she's not the type to go along with the plans I have for her. She's extremely virtuous and not given to thoughts of love, She has a rich husband who lets her dominate him, and though he is no longer young, he's certainly not over the hill yet. Nor does she have neighbours or relatives who can escort her to soirees, parties, or to other usual social occasions for young people. It's like she's living in a prison.
Her character has not the slightest speck of corruption in it.
Well then, what are you going to do?
Nothing is ever so impossible that there isn't some way of doing it. Even though my hope may very well be fragile and vain, a man's desire and determination to accomplish a difficult task will blind him to the chances of failure.
What is it that gives you hope?
Two things.
The first is the stupidity of Messer Nietzsche, who was the dumbest, most foolish man in Sardinia, in spite of his law degree. The second is the desire of both Nietzsche and Lucrezia to have children, for they have been married 6 years without any, and they are rich and do not want to die without heirs.
Come to think of it, Ciro, a third reason comes to mind as well. Lucrezia's mother wasn't exactly a saint in her younger days, but she's rich now, and I don't quite know how to handle her.
Have you made a move yet?
Yes, I have, but nothing serious.
What do you mean?
Well, you know Ligurio, who often eats with us? He used to be a marriage broker, but now he simply begs his meals. I've become his friend and have told him of my passion, and he's agreed to help me in any way possible.
Careful he doesn't trick you too. These sponges are not to be trusted.
I know that, but when you need someone, you have to trust them. If we're successful, I promised him some money. And if not, well, at least he'll earn a meal. Besides, I don't like eating alone.
What's he agreed to do so far?
Well, he's agreed to persuade Messer Nietzsche to accompany Lucrezia to the mineral baths in May.
How does that fit in with your plan?
What do you mean? Such a locale could change your prudish nature. As all one does at these places is have a good time. You see, I would go there myself and arrange all sorts of amusing things for us to do to show me off in the best possible way. I mean, after all, I could become friendly with them both, perhaps. I mean, who knows? Only time will tell. But like I said, Sarah, one thing does lead to another, and another, and another, and another, and so on and so forth.
It might just work.
So, are you with me, Sarah?
I'm your faithful Ciro. I've never questioned or judged your motives. I've always served you and will continue to do so.
Good. Because Liguria left this morning to speak to Messer Nietzsche about it. And he'll let me know how things turn out on his return.
And when's his return?
Anytime now.
I'll keep out of sight. In the meantime, you go about your duties. If I need you for anything, I'll let you know. Arrivederci.
Arrivederci.
I think your advice is sound, and I spoke to my wife about it last night, and she promised to give me an answer today. But to tell you the truth, I, for one, am not very excited about going. Do you, Vini?
Why?
Because basically, I want to stay at home. And then to have to move my wife, my servants, and my baggage doesn't suit me. Besides this, last night I spoke with several doctors. One of them says to go to San Filippo, another to Peretta, and third to La Villa, and so on. I think they're all a bunch of frauds. Tell you the truth, these doctors don't know what they're talking about.
I think you're disturbed more for the first reason you mentioned. You're used to having the Duomo of Sassari in view.
Yeah, you are mistaken. When I was younger, I was quite the Roma. There's not a fair in Alghero that I didn't visit. There's not a castle around here I haven't been to. What's more, I've even been as far as Pisa and Livorno. What do you say to that?
Did you see the sea at Livorno?
I certainly did see it.
How much bigger is it than the River Arno, for example?
The Arno? It's, 20 times bigger. You don't see anything but water, water, more water.
Well, I certainly am surprised that you find so much difficulty going to a spa, seeing as you've passed so much water in so many other places.
Oh, don't be simple. Moving an entire household is entirely different. Nevertheless, I want children so much, I'm ready to do anything. I tell you what, why don't you talk to these doctors about it and find out where they would advise me to go? Meanwhile, I'll go home to my wife, and you and I'll meet up there.
As you wish.
Good. Until then.
I don't think there's anyone in the whole world as stupid as he is. Yet fortune has been so kind to him. He's rich, he has a beautiful wife, who is wise, has good manners, and is fit to rule a kingdom. Why is it that the finest women always marry the fools? Yet, from Nietzsche's stupidity, some good may come. Callimaco has hope.
Oh, Callimaco! What are you doing here?
I saw you with Messer Nietzsche and waited for you to get rid of him so I could find out what you decided.
Due vini. He's exactly the kind of man you described. He has the prudence of a suckling pig. He would only leave Sassari reluctantly, but I encouraged him, and finally he told me frankly that he was ready to do anything to have children. So I'm sure we could get him to leave, but I'm no longer sure that it suits our needs.
Why?
Well, all sorts of people go to these baths. Someone might turn up who is richer and better looking than you. Then all our efforts would benefit the competition.
Well, I realize what you're saying is true, but what am I to do? Where am I to turn? What choice do I have? I must try something grandiose or dangerous or ruinous or infamous, or I'd rather die, Ligurio.
Control yourself.
I conjure up schemes like this just to keep calm, can't you see? Either we go ahead with our original plan to send them to the baths, or we have to come up with a new plan just to keep me from so much torment.
You're right. And I'm the one to do it.
I believe it. I know people like you live by deception. However, I don't feel you will trick me, because if you do and I catch you, I will do everything to get even with you. And then you will lose my hospitality and the chance of anything I promised you in the future.
You can trust me, caro Callimaco. Listen, Messer Nietzsche gave me the task of finding a doctor and deciding which baths would be the best to choose. Now you do as I tell you. Say that you've studied medicine and practiced in Paris. He's bound to believe you because he's an utter simpleton and you are learned and can recite a few phrases to him in Latin.
How will this help?
Use your noggin. It will help send him to whichever baths we choose. It will also enable me to put in place another plan I have in mind, one which will be simpler, more certain, more likely to succeed.
What are you saying?
You just keep your courage up. Put your trust in me. I'll see to it you have your wish by this time tomorrow.
You're reviving me, Liguria. But this is too great a promise. Now I have too great a hope. How will you do it?
You'll learn all about it later. There's little enough time for action, far less for words. Go home, wait for me there. But when I turn up with Messer Nietzsche, be sure to take your cue from me.
I'll do just as you say. But I fear the hope you've given me will go up in smoke.
Just pay the bill, and let's get to work.
Secondo me questo rinascimento non dura.
E perché?
I materiali sono scadenti e fra 50 anni bisogna ricostruire tutto. È una falsa economia.
Scusa, allora i grandi palazzi di Firenze, Palazzo Ducale, gli Uffizi?
Soprattutto questi.
As I was telling you, I believe God has sent us this man to help fulfill your wish. He's had a great deal of experience in Paris. But don't be surprised if he's not practiced medicine here in Sassari. There's no need to. For two reasons. First, because he's rich. Second, he may be returning to Paris any time.
That's what concerns me. I don't want him to get me into a pickle and leave me holding the bag.
Don't worry about that. Just worry about the possibility of his not taking your case. But I assure you, if he does, he won't abandon you. He'll see it through to the very end.
I leave that problem to you. As for his qualifications, as soon as I speak to him, I shall be able to tell whether he is competent or not. I'm not the kind of man that can be taken in.
Of course not. It's precisely because you're the kind of man I know you to be that I am taking you in, to meet him. And if you do not think he's an able man, after examining him, his learning, his manner of speech, then I am no longer an honest man.
Well, for God's sake, let's get on with it. Where does he live?
He lives right here in the square. Through this door.
Oh, good. You knock.
Who's there?
Ligorio. Just open the door.
All right, then.
Who is it that wants to see me?
Bona dies, Domine Doctor.
Et vobis bona, Domine Magister.
What do you say to that?
Christ, I'm impressed.
You two are going to have to speak so that I can understand you. Otherwise, we won't get anywhere.
What brings you here? Please.
Well, to tell you the truth, I don't know where to begin. I'm looking for two things that most men would avoid. To bring trouble to myself and to others. I don't have any children, and I want them. And to bring this trouble upon myself, I have come to trouble you.
It never troubles me to serve men of merit and breeding such as your good self, monsieur. After all, I did not spend so many years in Paris studying my art for any other reason but to serve you and your peers.
French as well as Latin?
Oui, oui.
Popery?
I'm glad of this. If you ever need my professional skill, I'll help you gladly. But let us return ad rem nostrum. Have you decided which bath would be good to encourage my wife to become pregnant? I know that Ligurio here has told you of our problem.
Yes, this is true. But firstly, to fulfill your desire, we must ascertain why your wife is sterile, as there are many possible causes. Aut in semine, aut in matrice, aut in instrumentis seminaris, aut in Viagra, aut in causa extrinsica.
Ligurio. Best doctor in the world.
Sir, could you remove your codpiece, please? Yes, indeed, of course, your wife's sterility could be caused by your own impotence. Now, if this was the case, there would be no remedy.
Me? Impotent? Don't make me laugh. I'm the healthiest and most virile man in all Sardinia.
Well, if this is true, then rest assured, we shall find a remedy.
Can't we find something besides the baths? I don't want the inconvenience, and my wife will leave Sassari only against her will.
There is one solution. If I may be so bold, Dottore, haven't you told me that you can mix certain potions that guarantee pregnancy?
Yes, yes, this is true. But I'm careful about discussing these matters with people I don't know very well, since they might take me for a charlatan.
Oh, you can rely on me. You've impressed me so much, I'd believe anything you say or do.
I suppose you'd need a urine sample.
Oh, yes, a urine sample, of course. We can't do without a urine sample.
Oh, right.
No, not from you, from your wife. Call Ciro. He can go with the counselor and get it, and we'll meet you at the square.
Ciro!
Sir?
Come here. Take this bottle and accompany Messanica to his house. And, sir, you come back as quickly as possible, if it suits you, and we shall think of a solution to the problem.
What do you mean, if it suits me? I'll be back in no time at all.
I have more faith in you than a Hun in his sword.
Your master is truly a worthy man.
More than you know.
The King of France must hold him in great esteem.
Indeed.
That must make him happy to live in France.
Yes, it does.
He has the right idea. Here, all we have are blockheads who have no idea how to appreciate talent. If he lived here, no one would even notice him. I know what I'm talking about. I had to ship blood to learn a few legal terms. If I had to live on that, I'd be in bad trouble, I tell you.
Do you earn 100 ducats a year?
Ducats? Not even 100 lira. Listen, if you're not working for the government in this town, you won't even find a dog that will bark at you. Right. You stay here, I'll get a piss.
If all educated men were like that one, we'd all go mad. It looks like that rascal Ligurio and my crazy master are leading Messanica to disaster. I'm all for it, as long as we don't get caught. If we do, my skin's in danger, as well as my master's life and goods. He has already become a doctor in medicine. Who knows what his plan is or where it will lead? But here comes the lawyer with a bottle of piss in his hand. Who would not laugh at this trick? That was quick.
She has a weak bladder. What a job it was to get that silly woman to give him this urine. I don't mean she doesn't want children, she wants them more than I. But whenever I try to do something about it, she gives me a hard time.
Have patience. With sweet words, you can make a woman do anything you want.
Sweet words, you say? Oh, Christ, I could do with a drink.
The lawyer will be easy to persuade that his wife may be a problem. Yet I think I have a way.
Sir, do you have the specimen?
Ciro has it.
Give it here. Ah, yes. This urine shows signs of a weak kidney.
Yes, does look a bit cloudy, but she just passed it a moment ago.
It's still warm.
Well, don't be surprised by its appearance. Nam mulieris urinae sunt semper maioris crucitei, et albedinis, est minoris pulchritudinis quam virorum, huis autem causa est in cetera amplitudo canalium, qua ex matrice exuent com urina.
Just as I thought.
By St. Puccio's twat, he really knows how to talk. The more I know him, the smarter he becomes.
I would say that your wife's urine is cloudy because she's not well covered at night.
She usually wears a long nightgown. However, before she comes to bed, she's like an animal out in the cold, 4 hours on her knees, muttering Our Fathers.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses.
Well, Counselor, either you trust me or you don't. Either I give you a sure cure or not. And if you trust me, you shall take the remedy. And if you do not have a baby boy within a year, I will give you 3,000 ducats.
Go on, tell me. I'll do anything you say. I trust you more than my confessor.
Well, then first you must understand this. The surest way to make a woman pregnant is to give her a potion to drink made from the mandrake root.
The mandrake root?
The mandrake root?
The mandrake root.
A mandragola.
Yes, the mandrake root. It's a tried and true remedy I've used on several occasions to great success. In fact, if it were not so, the Queen of France herself would still be sterile, not to mention an infinite number of noble ladies of that country.
When should she take it?
Oh, this evening, as the moon would be just right, and there couldn't be a better moment.
Prepare the potion. I'll make her take it. There won't be any problem.
There is one drawback. The first man to sleep with a woman who has taken this medicine will die within 8 days, and there's nothing anyone can do to save him.
Bugger me!
That's ridiculous! Call yourself a doctor! I've never heard anything so ridiculous all my life!
As far as I'm concerned, you go straight back to France. You really fixed me up like a...
A kipper?
Yes, a kipper.
Calm yourself, Counselor. There is a way.
What way?
You make someone else sleep with your wife, and in doing so that evening, he will draw the poison of the mandrake upon himself.
I wouldn't do that.
Why?
Because I don't want to turn my wife into a whore, myself into a cuckold. And then there's a small matter of killing someone.
Counselor, I took you for a smarter man. Do you mean to say that you would hesitate in following the King and Queen of France and most of the French nobility in these affairs?
But who do you think I could find to do such a crazy thing? If I warn him, he won't agree. If I don't say anything, I'll trick him and commit a criminal offence. I don't want to get into trouble.
If that is all that troubles you, leave everything to me.
But how can you possibly arrange all this?
I'll tell you. I'll give you the potion this evening, after supper. You give it to your wife to drink 4 hours after dark. And then, Ciro, Ligurio, yourself and I will disguise ourselves and go looking in the new market and the old market and the flea market. Oh, and around here for the first loafer to come along. We'll grab him and gag him and force him into your house and up the stairs and into your bed, and we'll tell him what to do, and there won't be any trouble at all. When he wakes in the morning, we'll kill him. No, we'll kick him out. And you then wash up your wife, and you can use her as you wish without any fear.
Well, I'm glad you say that kings and noblemen and princes use this method. But more than that, I'm glad no one will find out about it.
Who would tell?
There's one small obstacle that still remains.
What's that?
The wife. I'm not sure she'll ever agree to it.
Ah, yes, yes. Well, I wouldn't call myself a husband if I couldn't dominate my own wife, sir.
I think I have a solution.
What is it? Yes, what is it?
Her confessor.
Her confessor?
Her confessor?
Her confessor?
Her confessor?
Her confessor?
Her confessor? Yes, her confessor.
But who will convince him?
Yes, who will convince him?
Yes, who will convince him? You? Me? Money? Human nature? And the way priests are?
I'm afraid that if I suggest it to her, she won't go and see her confessor.
There is even a remedy for that.
Tell me.
Yes, tell him.
Have her mother take her.
Good idea. She trusts her mother.
And I know her mother thinks the way we do. Come on, hurry up. It's getting late. Kalimako, take a walk. But be sure to meet us 2 hours after dusk with the potion. Masanicha and I will go and see her mother, since I know her well. Then we'll go and see the priest at St. Caterina and tell you what we've done.
Well, until then.
Ligurio, non ce la faccio più.
Go and mix the potion.
The potion, yes.
I have often heard that a wise man chooses the lesser of two evils. If there is no other way to have children, then you must choose this method. If it does not bother your conscience.
That's right. You go and find your daughter. Your son-in-law and I will find Brother Timoteo, her confessor, and tell him of the problem so you don't have to. Then we'll see what he tells you.
Let's do that. You go that way. I'll look for Lucrezia and take her to speak to the priest and see what happens.
You're probably wondering, Ligurio, why I have to go to so much trouble to persuade my wife. But if you knew everything, you wouldn't be.
I think it's because women are suspicious by nature.
Oh, it's not just that. She used to be the sweetest, most docile person in the world. Then, one of the neighbors told her that if she vowed to hear the first morning mass for 40 days in a row, she would conceive. She swore to do so, and she attended mass about 20 times. Then, one of those horny priests started to pester her. Since then, she didn't want to go back. She's been as nervous as a hare. Suggest anything to her, and she'll find 1,000 objections.
I'm not surprised. Have you got 25 ducats? Because we'll need to spend a bit in order to make this priest our friend and encourage him to hope for more.
Take it. Money's no problem. I'll get it back somewhere else.
These priests are astute and very clever. It's only natural since they know our sins as well as their own. But if you're not experienced, you don't know how to get them to help you, they have a nasty habit of tricking you.
Just tell me what to do.
Leave all the talking to me. Don't say anything unless I give you a sign.
Agreed. But what sign will you give me?
I'll wink and bite my lip. No, that won't work. How long is it since you saw the confessor?
More than 10 years.
Good. Then we'll say that you've become deaf. And you're not to say anything unless we shout at you.
I'll do just that.
And don't be surprised if I say something that appears to be beside the point. I know what I'm doing.
Good. Until then.
Vedi? Non usa neanche vernice lucida. Prendi quel tizio, Michelangelo, ad esempio. Quello usa pittura d'acqua.
Perché secondo te?
Costa meno e è più facile pulire i pennelli.
Allora quel tipo. Michelangelo?
Daltonico.
Daltonico, incredibile. Scusa, allora come facciamo a fare tutti quei quadri, tutta con l'architettura?
Ma quello si metteva lì sopra il cavalletto, due macchie.
È sempre tutta l'acqua.
E per forza, l'acqua non costa niente.
Ma non era daltonico.
Ma vedevo l'acqua è bianca e chiara, ma si capisce niente come si.
E allora bastava usare quella d'olio.
Quella l'olio macchia, ti fa le macchie olio qua, ti fa tutte le macchie.
E allora si poteva usare quella d'acqua.
If you want to confess, I am ready to serve you.
Not today, thanks. I have an appointment. I just wanted to get a few things off my chest. By the way, have you said those masses to Our Lady?
Yes, I have.
So, take this florin and say the Mass of the Dead every Monday for 2 months in the name of my late husband. Even though he was a brute, the flesh is weak. And when I remember him sometimes, I can't help but feel a shiver. But do you really think he's in purgatory now?
Oh, beyond any shadow of a doubt.
I'm not so sure. You know very well what he did to me sometimes. Oh, how tired I am of bothering you about him. I kept away from him as much as I could. But he was so insistent. Oh, our Lord in heaven.
Oh, our Lord in heaven. Don't worry. Great is God's mercy. And if a man's will is not lacking, there is always time to repent.
Do you think the Turks will invade Italy this year?
They will if you don't say your prayers.
Oh, my fate. God preserve us from those devils. I have a very great fear of being impaled by these Turks. Oh, I see a friend of mine here in church who has something for me. I'll have to go to meet her. Goodbye to you.
Go in God's name, my beautiful, beautiful child. Women are the most charitable creatures in the world and the most troublesome. If you avoid them, you avoid problems. But then you also avoid certain advantages. If you deal with them, you have both the advantages and the problems. I suppose it's true that you can't have honey without flies. What brings you, gentlemen, here? Don't I recognize Messer Nietzsche?
You'll have to speak louder, Father. He's become so deaf, he can hardly hear a word. Ah.
Welcome, sir.
Louder.
Welcome. I'm happy to be here. What brings you here? I'm very well, thank you.
Talk to me, Father. For him to hear, you'd have to bring down the whole square.
So, what do you seek of me?
Messer Nietzsche and another fine gentleman, who you'll hear about later, have several hundred ducats to distribute as alms.
Bloody shit!
Pay no attention to him, Father. He doesn't hear, but sometimes he thinks he does, and answers without making sense.
You go on, and let him say what he wants.
Well, of these alms, I have a portion with me, they have decided that you are the man to distribute them.
Oh, I shall be happy to do so.
But before we give you the money, you must help with a strange case concerning Messer Nietzsche. Only you can help us. It's a question concerning the honor of his entire household.
Well, tell me all about it.
Well, you may know Camillo Calfucci, Messer Nietzsche's nephew.
Yes, I know him.
Well, a year ago, he went to France on business. Having lost a wife earlier, he left his daughter in the care of a convent, whose name I'd rather not divulge right now.
Well, what happened?
Well, what happened was, either due to the carelessness of the sisters or the stupidity of the girl, she now finds herself 2 months pregnant.
No.
Yes. So that unless we patch things up with prudence, not only Messer Nietzsche, but the girl, Camillo, and the entire Calfucci family will be disgraced. And Messer Nietzsche is so concerned about the scandal that he is willing to give 300 ducats for the Lord's work, if this can be kept secret.
That's marvelous.
That's ridiculous.
It's a matter that only you and the abbess can remedy.
How do you mean?
Persuade the abbess to give the girl something to make her miscarry.
This is something I shall have to think about.
Then just think how much good could come from this one act. You'd preserve the honor of the convent and of the girl. You'd return a maiden to her father. Satisfy Messer Nietzsche here. You'd distribute alms to the value of 300 ducats. And on the other hand, you're only doing away with a piece of unborn flesh without feelings. Something that might just as well die in 1,000 other ways. And I believe that whatever pleases the majority is good in itself.
So be it, in God's name. May everything you wish be done for God's sake and for the sake of charity. Now, all I need is the convent's address, the potion, and, if you want, the money. So that it can start doing some good.
Now you're beginning to be the priest I thought you were. Take this portion of the money. The convent is... Just wait a moment. There's a woman from church calling me. I'd better go and speak with her. Don't leave Messer Nietzsche here alone. I only need 2 words with her.
So, how much time does the girl have left?
I'm furious.
I said, how much time does the girl have left?
Curse him!
Why?
I hope he breaks his neck.
I'm dealing with a madman and a deaf man. One runs away, the other can't hear. But if there's a profit to be made here, I'll be shrewder than they are. Oh, here comes that scoundrel Ligurio.
Shut up. Father, I have wonderful news.
What is it?
The woman I spoke to told me the girl miscarried herself.
That's marvellous. Then these alms can go into the general account.
What do you mean?
I mean that now, you have even better reason to give alms.
The alms will be given in due course, but first there is another matter in which Messer Nietzsche could use your help.
Oh, yes, what is it?
Something less pressing, less scandalous, more acceptable to ourselves, and more profitable to you.
Well, tell me about it. We are on such good terms and are so agreeable that there is nothing I would not do for you.
And I'll tell you about it in church, privately. And Messer Nietzsche will be happy to wait for us here. We'll be right back.
Is it day or night? Am I awake or dreaming? Am I drunk? No, I haven't been able to touch a drop because of all this. We arranged to say one thing to the priest, then he says something completely different. I have to pretend to be deaf. I'm down 25 ducats. We haven't even begun discussing my problem, and now they left me standing here like some dumb ox. Ah, oh, here's Ligurio. And a curse on him if he hasn't been discussing my problem.
Brother Timoteo has agreed to do everything he can to help resolve our little problem.
Oh, that's a weight off my mind. Will it be a boy?
A boy it will be.
Oh, I'm so happy.
Gentlemen, I understand perfectly what I have to do. Now, you two go and wait in the church and stay out of sight. I shall await the ladies here, and when they've gone, I'll let you know what their reaction was. May God smile upon your endeavors. May his face shine upon you. And may our souls forever dwell in heaven. I don't know who's fooling who. That rascal Ligurio came to me with the first story in order to test me, so that if I failed to help him in the first affair, he would have said nothing of the other, in order not to reveal their true plans. Whatever. Oh, yes, it's obvious that I've been tricked, but this ruse can still be profitable to me. Messer Nietzsche and Calamacchio are both rich, so I should be able to get quite a bit out of them for various reasons. Obviously, this affair must remain secret, since that is as much in my own interest as in theirs. But whatever happens, I'll have no regrets. In fact, I don't give a donkey's turd. Oh, yes. Yes, there may be problems along the way. Madonna Lucrezia is clever and kind. So I shall play upon her kindness. Anyway, women aren't too bright. Oh, come on. If they can string a few words together, they're considered a genius. But remember, in the land of the blind, the one-eyed man is king. There she is, with her mother, a woman of loose morals and easy virtue. She'll be of use to me in convincing her daughter. Fun, isn't it?
I'm sure you realize, Lucrezia, that I value your reputation as much as anyone in the world. And I wouldn't advise you to do anything that wasn't right. I've told you before, and I'm telling you now, that if Brother Timoteo tells you there is nothing to burden your conscience about, you can do it without further thought.
I've always been afraid that Nietzsche's desire to have children would get us into trouble. Because of this, I'm always suspicious whenever he comes up with a new scheme. Especially after my bad experience in church, as you know. But of all the things he's dreamt up, this is by far the strangest. To have to submit my body to this outrage. To be the cause of a man's death because of such a disgrace. If I were the last woman on earth, and the future of the human race depended on me, I don't think I could go through with it.
Oh, I don't know how to explain certain things to your daughter. Speak to the priest, see what he has to say, and then do what he advises, and what we who love you advise you to do.
Welcome. Welcome, both of you. Now, I know what you want me for, since Messer Nietzsche has spoken to me. To tell you the truth, I have been paging through my books for more than 4 hours to study this case and have found numerous entries, both in particular and in general, which seem almost made for us.
Are you speaking the truth or just joking?
Oh, Madonna, are these matters one jokes about? Don't you know me yet?
Yes, I know you, Father, But this is the strangest thing I've ever heard.
Madonna, I believe you. But I don't want you to carry on this way. Many things appear terrible, unsupportable, and strange from a distance. But when you approach them, they become normal, bearable, and quite common. That is why they say that fear itself is often worse than the evil we fear. This is such a case.
I hope to God it is.
As far as your conscience is concerned, you should take this as a general rule, that where there is a certain good and an uncertain evil, the good should never be avoided for fear of the evil. In your case, the certain good is that you will conceive and produce a soul for our Lord. The uncertain evil is that the man who sleeps with you after you take the mandrake potion may die. And then again, it's possible he may not die. As far as the act itself is concerned, whether or not it is a sin is foolish to discuss, for it is the will that sins, not the body. No. The true sin is to displease your husband, but you will be pleasing him, taking pleasure in the act which displeases you. Besides which, in all things, one must look to the result.
The outcome of your act will be to please your husband and fill a seat in paradise. The Bible says that the daughters of Lot, believing themselves to be alone in the world, lay with their father. But because their intent was good, they did not sin.
What is your counsel then?
Oh, just let yourself be counseled, daughter. Don't you see that a childless woman has no security? If her husband dies, she is left like a stray animal, abandoned by everyone.
Madonna, I swear to you by this holy cross that humoring your husband in this way will bring you no more spiritual grief than would, say, eating meat on a Wednesday. And that is a sin which can be removed by holy water.
Where are you leading me, Father?
I am leading you towards something for which you will always be thankful in your prayers. And you'll be even more grateful in about 9 months from now.
Oh, silly girl. What are you afraid of? There are 50 girls in town who would thank God to be in your shoes.
Very well. But I don't think I'll be alive in the morning.
Don't worry, my child. I shall pray to God for you and ask the angel Raphael to comfort you. Now go. Go and prepare yourself for this holy miracle.
Peace be with you, Father. Well done.
Our God and our Father, protect me from harm.
God smile upon your endeavors. May his face shine upon you. And may our souls...
How did it go?
Very well. She's agreed to do everything. And there won't be any problems. Her mother's promised to put her to bed herself.
Are you telling the truth?
Jesus, you're cured of your deafness.
Yes, St. Brian has granted him this miracle.
Oh, jubilati Deo. You will naturally want to donate an ex voto to spread the word. And this way, the church itself can profit.
Let us not change the subject. Will she give us any problems in doing what I wish?
No, I tell you.
I'm the happiest man in the world. I could
soon be the father of a fine bouncing boy, and to hell with those without your luck.
Father, you get back to your devotions. If we need you, we know where to find you. Messer Nietzsche, you should follow your wife. Keep her from changing her mind. I'll ask Dr. Calamarco to send the potion, or we'll meet again after dark to arrange what else needs to be done.
Until then.
May God smile upon your endeavors. May his face shine upon you. And may... whatever.
Kalimako, what took you?
Any news?
Good news.
Really good?
The best.
Lucrezia has agreed?
Yes.
And the friar did his job?
He certainly did.
Oh, I will pray to God for that blessed friar.
Yeah, he'll want something beside your prayers.
What does he want?
Cash.
How much did you promise him?
400 ducats.
He did well, Lucrezia.
Yeah, and Messanicha's already forked out 10 of them.
Messanicha?
Yeah. And her mother took her to see the priest, and they worked it all out together, and Lucrezia has given her consent.
Oh, what have I done for such good fortune? I'm so happy I could die.
What is it with this guy? First he wants to die of grief, then he wants to die of happiness. Seems to want to croak any way he can.
Have you got the potion?
Yes, I do.
What are you sending?
Hippocras tea. Just the thing to calm the mind and warm the heart. Oh, dear God in heaven! Jesus Christ, I'm ruined!
What is it? What are you talking about?
There's no way out!
Oh, God, what the hell's going on?
We haven't gotten anywhere and I've painted myself into a corner, Ligurio!
What's the problem?
Well, can't you see? I told Messanicha that Ciro, you and I would find someone to lie with his wife.
So what?
What do you mean, so what? If I'm with you, I can't be the one who's kidnapped. And if I'm not the one who's kidnapped, then he will discover the trick.
Oh, I see. You're right. But surely there's a way around this.
I don't think so.
Yes, there is.
What?
Just let me think of it.
I'm stuffed if you have to start thinking at this point.
I've got it.
What?
We'll let the priest take care of this, seeing as it's helped us so far.
How?
We'll all disguise ourselves. I'll dress the priest. We'll change his face, his voice, and his clothes. I'll tell the counselor he is you, and he's bound to believe it.
That's fine, but what do I do?
You can turn up wearing a short cloak, and carrying a lute. Then you can sing a little song about an aubergine.
Why not a carrot?
An aubergine's better.
Without a mask?
Yes, without a mask. If you wore a mask, he'd suspect you.
But then he'll recognize me.
No, he won't, because you can distort your face. So open your mouth, close one eye, and just lick your eyebrow with your tongue. That's it. Remember that. I've got a false nose at home. You can wear that too.
What else?
Well, when you turn up at the block, we grab you and your lute, spin you around a bit, bring you in the house, throw you in the bed. You'll have to do the rest yourself.
Well, that's where the hard part starts.
Well, one would hope so. But you just make sure you can get back in again.
What do you mean?
Just that you should take her tonight and then explain the trick to her. Show her your love. Tell her how much you care for her and explain how, without any scandal at all, she could become your lover. And how scandalous it would be to become your enemy. It's impossible that she won't see the light or that she would want tonight to be the last night.
You really believe this?
I'm sure of it. Come on, hurry up. Call Ciro. Send the potion to Messanicha's. I'll go to the priest, disguise him, and bring him back here. And together we'll go to Nietzsche's and work out what else needs to be done.
Fine. Get going. Oh. Ciro?
Sir?
Oh. Oh, sorry. Take this potion to Nietzsche's house. And don't spill a drop on the way. Well, yeah, just get going. If he wants, wait with him. And if not, then come back. Or just go.
Worthy man.
Is he lame or just pretending?
Mind your own business. For Christ's sake, shut up or you'll ruin the whole thing. Where's Kalimako?
Here I am. Do you have the chalice?
You spoke to Messanicha.
Yes, sir.
And what did he say?
That he'll be at your services shortly.
And Liguri, you have your disguises?
I have. Let's do it in the bushes.
Cyril.
You must be Kalimako.
Indeed I am, yes. Our contract is drawn.
My fortune is at your disposal, and you can use it as if it were your own.
I understand everything and believe in it. Therefore, I have done for you what I would not have done for another person in the whole world.
You shall not be sorry.
Oh, it's enough that you think kindly of me.
Fare thee well, Friar.
How do we look?
Unbelievable.
Bah.
The lawyer's late. We're going to have to go and get him. It's already gone 11.
Someone's coming.
What the hell's he wearing? Good evening, counselor. Don't be afraid. It's only us.
Oh, you're here. If I hadn't recognized you, I'd give you all a whack with my sword. The guru, Sarah. And this is your master. Good. Let me have a closer look. You're disguised so well. Not even the sheriff would know him.
Yes, I had him put a pebble in his mouth so no one would recognize his voice.
You are stupid.
Why?
Why didn't you tell me about the pebble in the mouth? You know how important it is for people not to recognize our voices.
Here. Put this in your mouth.
You dirty bastard! Well,
it looked like a little brown pebble.
Doctor, aren't you going to say anything?
I'm very angry with Ligurio for doing that.
Oh, how well you disguise your voice. You sound just like that fat priest.
How dare you speak to me like that?
Oh, very good, very good.
Look, we're losing time here. I'll be the general and set up our army for battle. Dr. Calimaco, you take the right horn. That's you. I'll take the left horn. Messanicio, you stay in the middle. Ciro, you take up the rear guard and help anyone who falls behind. The password will be Sankokold.
Sankokold? Who's Sankokold?
He's the most venereal saint in France.
We'll set our ambush here at the corner. I hear a lute playing.
It's a man. What should we do?
We'll send a scout to the front to find out who he is. And depending what he reports back to us, we'll take it from there.
Who will go?
Ciro, you go. You know what to do. Investigate, make inquiries, return immediately and report back to us.
We don't want to make the mistake of picking up someone weak or ill. Otherwise, we'll have to repeat this operation tomorrow night.
Don't worry. Ciro knows what to do. Here he is coming back.
What did you find out? He's the most handsomest young rate you've ever saw. No more than 25 years old, alone, shabbily dressed, and playing a lute.
If you're right, he's just what we need.
Wait! Wait till he turns the corner and we'll all jump him at once.
Doctor, you've been so quiet all evening.
Oh, he's here.
Let's go.
E buona sai liquida, più buona di la fava, più buona di l'anghita, e secondi da me. Un'aria e peperoni, ti friggio un bella canna, la melinzana, ti friggio un bella canna, la melinzana, tra la la.
Oh,
Sinitia, I'm going home for a nap. My beard is killing me. If you won't be needing me, I will not be back until tomorrow morning.
That's very good, very good. Yeah, that's fine, Doctor. We don't need you. We'll take care of everything ourselves. Let's get him in the house.
The sun's up, and I'm just in time. There's a terrible commotion coming from Messer Nietzsche's house. They're throwing their prisoner out of the door now. Oh, the lovers must have enjoyed themselves to the last drop. Anyway, I want to hear what they're saying, but I mustn't be seen. Shh.
Hello, don't hurt me.
Don't be afraid, just be on your way. Give him a couple of turns, Cyril, so we don't know where he came from. That's it, go on, you wretch, beat it. And if I hear you talking about this, I'll cut your throat.
He's run off. You and Sarah, go and find the doctor. Tell him everything went well.
But what did happen? We couldn't hear anything. We were locked in the wine cellar all night.
I'll tell you what happened. My wife was in bed in the dark. I wanted to see if he was healthy. What if he had the pox? Where would that leave me? Of course, I checked everything. The Sustrata.
Right, you. Bend over. What can you see?
Nothing.
What can you feel?
He's got a very hairy arse.
That's my beard.
Oh, sorry. Well, it all feels good to me.
Let me have a go.
Oh.
Oh, sorry. Let's put him in the bed. Right. Let's wait downstairs.
Shouldn't we stay and watch?
No.
We left the room and locked the door. In the morning, after enjoying his sauce, he finally got up. I called you, and here we are.
It's all gone according to plan.
You know, something worries me.
What's that?
That poor young man who has to die so soon. This one night cost him so dear.
You don't have to worry about that. That's his problem.
Of course. You're right. I can't wait to see Dr. Kalamako and congratulate him.
Well, he should be here within the hour.
I'll get my wife up and have a wash. And then I'll bring her to the church to have her purified. I'd like you and the doctor to be there. We should speak to the priest to thank him and reward him for all the good he has done.
Do you think we should change our clothes?
Yes, good idea.
I'm rather pleased the way that went, considering how stupid that lawyer is. But the part I liked most was what he said about my reward. Well, I mustn't linger here. They'll be looking for me at the church, where my services bring an even higher reward.
As I said, Liguri, my old friend, initially I was quite uneasy. But then I explained to her the plan, and she went along with it. And then told me, with great clarity, what she wanted.
Since your cunning, stupidity of my husband, the unscrupulousness of my mother and the evil nature of my confessor have made me do what I would never have done on my own, I shall have to believe it is some divine power that causes me to act in this way. And since I am not capable of resisting heaven's wishes, I accept. Therefore, I take you for Lord, Master, and Guide. You must be everything good. For me, you'll be my father, my defender. And what my husband wanted for one night, I now want him to have forever. Become his close friend, then. Be in church this morning, and from there you can come to dine with us here. And you can come and go as you will. And we can be together constantly and without suspicion.
And on hearing these words, Liguria, I tell you, I can't even express the smallest part of what I felt. But I am more blessed than the blessed, more saintly than the saints.
Well, I'm happy if you're happy. And it's all gone just as I told you it would. So what do we do now?
Well, we must to church, for I promised Sostrata, Lucrezia, and Messer Nietzsche that we would meet them there. Shall we go?
Sono palazzi fra 10 anni crolleranno, si sbriciola tutto perché li hanno costruiti con materiale scadente.
E i grandi artisti, Michelangelo, Leonardo da Vinci.
Leonardo da Vinci, sì.
Quello che ha fatto quella con i capelli lunghi.
Ha dipinto la Gioconda, che gli inglesi.
Mona Lisa.
In inglese Mona Lisa. Mona Lisa.
E poi, allora il Rinascimento inglese?
Rinascimento inglese, perché c'è un Rinascimento inglese? Certo, io non lo so, certo. Non lo so, ci sarà un Rinascimento inglese, ma noi non sappiamo.
Lucrezia, I think everything should be done prudently and not haphazardly.
Now, what is your complaint?
Oh, look how she answers, just like a proud cock.
Don't be too surprised. After all, she is a bit worked up. What's that supposed to mean?
I'd better speak to the priest to ask him to purify you.
Oh, it's truly fitting that you be reborn this morning.
Well, aren't you going then?
You are really something this morning. Last night you appeared almost dead.
That's thanks to you.
Go on and find the priest.
Underneath there he is.
Father!
May God be gracious unto you, and may he grant you a handsome boy, Madonna Lucrezia.
May God grant it.
Oh, he will. He certainly will.
Are Ligurio and Dr. Calimaco on their way?
Of course.
God save you all.
Ah! Oh, doctor!
Ligurio! Doctor, give my wife your hand.
Why not? She's had everything else.
Most happily.
Lucrezia, this is the man who will give us a stout support for our old age.
I am most grateful for that support, and I hope he becomes a very close friend of ours.
Oh, God bless you. I want you and Ligurio to dine with us this morning.
Of course.
I'm going to give them the key to the ground floor of the loggia, so that they can come and go as they please. They have no women to care for them, poor beasts.
I accept. Most gladly, and shall make use of it whenever my need arises.
Will I still get the monies for the arms?
You certainly will, Father. They'll be sent today.
Won't someone remember Ciro?
My friend. Let him ask. Whatever I have is his.
Lucrezia, what should we give Father Timoteo for cleansing you?
Give him 50 large ducats.
Oh, my God.
Lady Sostrata, you seem so much younger today.
I'm happy. Who wouldn't be today?
Exactly. Well, let's all proceed to the Duomo, where I shall say the required services. Then afterwards, you can all eat your fill. And may God smile upon your endeavors. May his face shine upon you, and may our souls. And so, my friends, our story's over. You've seen the tale of Mandragola. Go forth to live and laugh at life. But learn from the lover, the lawyer, and his wife.
Thank you.